एक बार फिर से आपका स्वागत है। एनडीटीवी और डेटॉल बनेगा स्वस्थ इंडिया अभियान में, और इस चरण में आइए हम बात करते हैं भारती चतुर्वेदी। आप फाउंडर डायरेक्टर हैं चिंतन एनवायरमेंटल रिसर्च एंड एक्शन ग्रुप की। हमारे साथ और भी लोग जुड़ रहे हैं, लेकिन मैं भारती से सबसे पहले सवाल पूछना चाहता हूँ। भारती, हाउ डू यू लुक एट दिस, यू नो दिस masks and gloves, which are now becoming a major problem in waste disposal. See, we look for solutions, and those solutions also end up creating problems. So I want to know with you, what can we do?
So that is a problem. It's a global problem. In fact, now the data is coming out that we've probably used by the end of this year about 129 billion masks and 65 billion gloves. And if you put them together, it will be the size of Switzerland. So there is a really big serious problem here. And there are very few things that we can do when we are in the peak of a pandemic, because our systems are weak. You know, you can do many things if you have a strong system. So one of the things that we definitely have to know is ki, you know, right now we are focusing on COVID waste that is coming out of COVID patients. But there are people in the house. Many of them are positive. We've just discovered from the results that, you know, up to a third of us might have been exposed. So I think the point is, the number one thing that is going to work in our country is you have to segregate your waste. You have to keep your dry waste separately for 3 days and then give it to whoever you're giving it to, the waste collector or giving it to anybody else. There is, you know, the simplest solutions can make a big change. It's like washing hands in COVID. It's a simple solution. Segregate your waste. Yes. But we find segregation levels are very low. People are not willing to do it.
Mm. Right.
You know.
Right.
I also feel just kind of adding to the whole conversation on segregation, I feel the education on the topic is so less. It's actually something so easy. Okay. You know, people just feel it's going to be so tedious. It's something that we've been following for the last few years at home, and literally हमारे घर से कचरा ना छोट मतलब बिल्कुल कम ही निकलता है अब, क्योंकि गीला कचरा हम कंपोस्टिंग कर देते हैं उसकी, जो भी दूसरा कचरा जो एक्चुअली लैंडफिल में जाना चाहिए वो हार्डली कम्स। सो आई थिंक द पॉइंट ऑफ सेग्रीगेशन इज ऑफ अटमोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंस, बिकॉज इफ एवरी हाउस होल्ड इन अर्बन इंडिया स्पेशली स्टार्ट्स डूइंग इट, आवर लैंडफिल्स विल बी होपफुली रिड्यूस्ड इन द फ्यूचर।
You know, there's also another challenge here, because we are talking about gloves or masks that might have COVID virus, but that virus only stays for 3 days maximum. So if you segregate it, and in fact, the law says that now this emergency guideline that we have, wrap it up in a piece of paper and keep it with you and give it after 3 days. What's the problem? Because if you don't do it, then that COVID will go in the community and come back to you. You know, someone else in your family. It's that simple. It's common sense.
एक और डायनामिक है जिसके बारे में यहाँ बात करनी चाहिए, और उसके लिए मेधा पाटकर सोशल एक्टिविस्ट हैं, co-founder and National Alliance of People's Movement, वो भी हमारे साथ जुड़ गई हैं। मेधा जी, can environment ever be protected without social justice?
I don't think it can. Because we talk about solutions, no doubt about it, and solutions are necessary, but why create problems? The problems are created not by those who live with nature. The natural resource-based communities show us the Gandhian path, because they are simple living, they are more self-reliant than anyone else. And if we do injustice to them by snatching away their land, their forests, their rivers, their minerals also underneath the land, then what is the result? It is not only displacement, it is destruction of the natural ecosystems. And when we disturb the ecosystems, we have not just coronavirus. We have a number of viruses which our agriculturists face on chilies, on soybean. And we have faced 5 big cyclones within last 3 years. Oki, Amphan, Vayu, Nisarga, so on. So all of that impact needs to be taken into consideration, and let the communities live their own ways, which are going to be the ways for the next generation and the next decade. And the injustice that is done to them is due to disparity. as one of the panelists spoke about, that is vulgarly growing in this country. Even after lockdown, the ways and means that are adopted to raise the GDP, which is not at all the indicator of health, not at all the indicator of equity, justice, self-reliance, socialism, or even the secularism, which are all values in the preamble of the Constitution, not just of the social activists. So it is necessary to understand that unless that justice is granted, we cannot really save either food and have food security. We cannot enjoy the benefits for the elites which they enjoy today. Because of their sacrifice, the others enjoy, whether it is air conditioned or the water from the big dams. So it is very necessary that we do justice. And if that disparity is not allowed to function or escalate, and we really have equitable distribution of resources, everyone will have its basic needs fulfilled. And what Mahatma Gandhi, today is the Gandhi Jayanti, had said, that the most valuable solution, we have enough on this earth to feed everyone. Why are 3,000 children dying of malnutrition every day in this country? That is heartburning. And hence, we must have justice to them. That will really save even the environment and natural resources, beyond consumerism, beyond corporatism, beyond centralization, beyond depletion, without any controls and monitoring, as EIA 2020 is going to bring in that new diluted regime of environmental law, will not pay any attention to environmental and social impacts. And that's what has been happening now, but it will be much more. That will be disastrous.
Correct.
1,500 and more scientists have already warned that it is just 30 years of life for all of us. The clock is ticking, and the climate change is killing agriculture to Himalayan glaciers.
Correct.
And that's why the sea is coming in. That's why the drought and flood cycle. We cannot forget this.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका मिताभ जी. मैं अमिताभ बच्चन बोल रहा हूँ और यहाँ पर हम आमंत्रित करना चाहेंगे बाघेल जी को. बाघेल जी, आपसे कुछ प्रश्न पूछने थे. पहले तो आपका स्वागत करते हैं हम आज के इस कार्यक्रम में. देखिए, शुरुआत में
जी नमस्कार.
जी नमस्कार. शुरुआत में कोरोना की जो रोकथाम थी वो काफ़ी सफल रही, लेकिन इधर देखा गया कि छत्तीसगढ़ में 300% बढ़ोतरी हुई है. ये कैसे संभव हो गया और इसकी वजह क्या है?
देखिए, सबसे पहली बात यह है कि छत्तीसगढ़ है वो 7 राज्यों से घिरा हुआ है. और उस समय आपने देखा होगा कि लॉकडाउन के समय हम लोगों ने जो कदम जो उठाए, उसमें सबसे पहले यह है कि हमने अपने सीमाओं को सील कर दिया था, और उसके कारण से बाहर के लोग नहीं आ पाए. एयरपोर्ट भी बंद था और रेलवे मार्ग भी बंद था. इसका फायदा यह हुआ कि जो बाहर से आए उसको आइडेंटिफाई किए, जो विदेश से आए उनको आइडेंटिफाई किए और उसका इलाज शुरू कर दिए. इस कारण से हमारे यहाँ जो कोरोना पॉजिटिव है वो केवल 3 तक के हम लोग ले आए थे, लेकिन जैसे ही सीमाओं को खोला गया, एयरपोर्ट शुरू किया गया, रेलवे स्टेशन में रेल आने शुरू हुए, और इसके कारण से जो बाहर से जो जितने भी लोग आए उसके कारण से हमारी संख्या बढ़ी. आपको पता है अमिताभ जी, हमारे यहाँ छत्तीसगढ़ में नक्सली समस्या है, तो बहुत सारे जवान पैरामिलिट्री फोर्स यहाँ डिप्लाई है, तो हजारों जो जवान जो छुट्टी से वापस लौटे वो कोरोना से संक्रमित थे. तो इस प्रकार से ये कंट्रोल के बाहर हुआ और आंकड़ा बढ़ा. लेकिन अभी हम लोग लगातार प्रयास कर रहे हैं और मैं समझता हूँ कि कोरोना से हम जीतने में सफल होंगे.
जी बघेल साहब, मैं संकेत बोल रहा हूँ आपसे, और हमारी लगातार चर्चा होती रही है समय समय पर. आपको मेरी आवाज आ रही है बघेल साहब? क्या आप मुझे सुन पा रहे
हो? रहा है
जी, इसको अभी सुधार लेते हैं. मैं अपना सवाल पूछता हूँ, संभवतः सुधर जाएगा ये भी. बघेल साहब, मैं आपसे ये सवाल पूछ रहा था कि इस कार्यक्रम में इससे पहले भी पिछले 6 महीने में आप जितनी बार एनडीटीवी पर आए हैं तो हमने लॉकडाउन आपके राज्य में भी हुआ और जगह भी हुआ उसके बारे में बात की, लेकिन देखिए देश को हर समय तो लॉकडाउन रख नहीं सकते। अभी भी आपने समस्या यही बताई कि जैसे ही लॉकडाउन खुला तड़ से वायरस अंदर आ गया आपके राज्य में, तो अब इसका सोल्यूशन क्या है, इसका हल क्या है, फिर लॉकडाउन या कुछ और?
नहीं, लॉकडाउन के बिल्कुल पक्ष में नहीं हूं। अब जो हम लोगों ने जो शुरुआत की है वो हम होम आइसोलेशन का, और इसमें हजारों लोग होम आइसोलेशन में हैं, इसका लाभ उठा रहे हैं। आप हॉस्पिटल में जितने भी मरीजों का इलाज हो रहा है उसमें देखेंगे सबसे ज्यादा जो शिकायत आती है कि डॉक्टर राउंड में नहीं आते, नर्स नहीं आते, और लोग अकेलेपन में अवसाद से ग्रसित होते जा रहे हैं। तो इससे बचने का सबसे बढ़िया तरीका है, यदि आपको और दूसरी बीमारियां नहीं हैं, आपको ज्यादा परेशानी नहीं हो रही है, तो होम आइसोलेशन में रहें, तो वो ज्यादा बेहतर फील कर रहा है जो मरीज है, और बहुत जल्दी वो स्वस्थ भी हो रहे हैं। दवाइयां हम घर घर बांट रहे हैं और लगातार उसे जो कॉल सेंटर है उसके माध्यम से हमारे डॉक्टर हैं और जो एक्सपर्ट हैं वो लगातार उसे संपर्क में, हर जिले में इसकी व्यवस्था कर दी गई है और हजारों के तादाद में लोग घर में हैं। और हमारे यहाँ अभी कोरोना पॉजिटिव की संख्या जो है वो 31,000 है
जी। बघेल जी, एक और बात पूछनी थी आपसे। देखिए, स्वच्छता और स्वास्थ्य ये एक दूसरे के साथ बहुत ही इनका गहरा संबंध है। आपने बहुत ही सफलता के साथ स्वच्छता जो हमारा अभियान था और जिसमें आप भी जुड़े थे उसे आपने चलाया। साफ सफाई इस महामारी के दौर में बहुत ही अहम भूमिका निभाती है। आपकी सबसे बड़ी सीख क्या मिली आपको इससे, क्योंकि सिर्फ एक स्वच्छ छत्तीसगढ़ ही स्वस्थ बन सकता है क्या?
देखिए, ये 3 विषय लिए हैं एनडीटीवी ने, स्वच्छता, स्वास्थ्य और पर्यावरण, और तीनों एक दूसरे से जुड़े हुए हैं। और जहां तक स्वच्छता की बात है तो छत्तीसगढ़ में हमारे 10,000 महिला समूह हैं, वो लगातार काम कर रही हैं और हमने पूरे देश में दूसरा स्थान प्राप्त किया है। साथ ही 16,000 टन कचरे का निपटारा हम लोग करते हैं, और ये भी एक हम लोगों ने स्वच्छ दीक्षा योजना भी शुरू किया है, जिसमें हर राज्य के लोग यहाँ आए हैं और प्रशिक्षण लिए हैं, और न केवल देश के भीतर बल्कि भूटान और नेपाल के भी टीम यहाँ आके स्वच्छता अभियान को देखा है, उसे सीखा है। ये हमारे जो महिलाएं हैं वो लगातार काम कर रही है, और ई रिक्शा वगैरह के माध्यम से इसका परिवहन करते हैं। यदि हम डीजल की गाड़ी करते तो करोड़ों रुपया, 2,000 करोड़ के आसपास खर्चा बैठता, लेकिन हम लोग लगभग 200 करोड़ के अंदर में, जिसमें हमारे जो महिला समूह है स्वच्छता दीदी, उनके भी मानदेय जो पहले 5,000 था उसे बढ़ा के 6,000 कर दिया, ये भी इसमें शामिल है। और अभी हम लोगों ने जो योजना शुरू की है नरवा गरवा घुरवा बाड़ी, और इसके माध्यम से हम लोग जो गोबर है वो भी एकत्रित कर रहे हैं, और इस 2 महीने में हम लोग हरेली के त्यौहार के दिन हम लोगों ने शुरुआत की, और इस 2 महीने में लगभग 11 लाख क्विंटल गोबर एकत्रित किए हैं, और जिसमें 20 करोड़ रुपये की राशि का भुगतान किया है। तो जहां एक तरफ इसमें साफ सफाई भी हो रहा है और दूसरी तरफ इसमें लोगों के आय में वृद्धि भी हो रही है, जो लैंडलेस लेबर है उसके लिए एक बहुत ही कारगर योजना है, और पूरे देश में और क्या पूरे विश्व में कह सकता हूँ ये पहली योजना है जिसे गोधन न्याय योजना के रूप में हमने शुरुआत की है, और इसका लाभ भी मिल रहा है। और जो गंदगी सड़कों पर पड़े रहते थे, चाहे वो शहर हो चाहे गांव हो, वो सब एकत्रित किया जा रहा है, और जिसके पास भी मवेशी है, जानवर है, उसके भी गोबर से उनको आय में वृद्धि हो रही है
जी।
पर्यावरण की जहाँ तक की बात है तो पर्यावरण के दिशा में हम लोगों ने काम किया। छत्तीसगढ़ में करीब 44% जंगल है, पूरे देश का 70% है, और पूरे देश को, मतलब दूसरे शब्दों में कहा जा सकता है कि देश को ऑक्सीजन देने में छत्तीसगढ़ का 17% योगदान है। तो ये और इस साल हम लोगों ने किया है कि ये वृक्षारोपण जो हम लोग करते थे उसमें फलदार वृक्षों का वृक्षारोपण करें, ताकि हमारे जो वनांचल में रहने वाले लोग हैं, हमारे आदिवासी हैं, उनको उस वृक्षारोपण से आने वाले समय में उसका रोजगार का उनके आय में आय का साधन बने, ये हमारी कोशिश है। जहाँ तक कि स्वास्थ्य की बात है, अभी मेघा पाटकर जी के भी मैं सुन रहा था और उन्होंने जो कुपोषण की बात कही, तो हमारे छत्तीसगढ़ में 37.7% बच्चे कुपोषित हैं। इस साल हमने 2 अक्टूबर, पिछले साल गांधी जयंती के दिन ही 2 अक्टूबर को हमने मुख्यमंत्री सुपोषण योजना की शुरुआत की, और मुझे बताते हुए प्रसन्नता हो रही है कि छत्तीसगढ़ में जो 5 लाख कुपोषित बच्चे हैं उसमें से 68,000, जिसका मतलब 13% से अधिक बच्चे कुपोषण से बाहर आए हैं, ये मुख्यमंत्री सुपोषण जो योजना चलाए हैं। उसी प्रकार से मुख्यमंत्री हाट बाजार क्लिनिक योजना, क्योंकि हमारे वनांचल में रहने वाले लोग हॉस्पिटल भले ना जाएं, शहर भले ना जाएं, लेकिन हाट बाजार जरूर जाते हैं, इस कारण से हाट बाजार क्लिनिक योजना हमने शुरू की है। पूरे जो मेडिकल टीम है वो हर हाट बाजार में जाते हैं, और वो करीब साल भर में, क्योंकि कोरोना काल शुरू हुआ उसके पहले तक के 26,000 हमारे कैंप लगे, जिसमें लाखों लोग, 8 लाख लोग इसका लाभ लिए हैं। तो इस प्रकार से स्वास्थ्य की दिशा में, कुपोषण के लड़ाई की दिशा में, और साथ ही पर्यावरण की दिशा में हम लोग लगातार काम कर रहे हैं।
माननीय आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, प्रणाम करते हैं हम आपको, और सारी बातें जो आपने कही उसका हम संजो करके रखेंगे अपने मन में। आई'd लाइक टू क्वेश्चन मिस्टर बेजवाड़ा नाउ। मिस्टर बेजवाड़ा, वी इन्वाइट यू टू दिस प्रोग्राम। यू नो, वी लास्ट स्पोक राइट हियर द लास्ट एडिशन ऑफ बनेगा स्वस्थ इंडिया टेलीथॉन। सो व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इन दिस इंटरवीनिंग पीरियड, यू नो, अबाउट द मैनुअल स्कैवेंजिंग दैट वाज पुट टू एन एंड टू ऑन पेपर इन 2013, बट हैज एनीथिंग चेंज्ड ऑन द ग्राउंड? And may I just speak a bit personally on this issue? The matter of manual scavenging has been an issue for many years. And on many programs of Swachh India, we've had invited some of them here and assured them that, you know, we will make provisions for them. Some of the things that came across were that manual scavengers were finding it difficult to find jobs because of the kind of work that they were asked to do and they were involved in. So during the last year when we spoke about this, I asked whether there is some kind of a machinery where the human being doesn't have to go down into the sewer to clean it. And I was given a manufacturing factory in, I think, Aurangabad. And I asked them if I could, you know, purchase some of them and give it to these scavengers. So I donated 50 such machines. And 25 of them I actually distributed to manual scavengers by calling them over to my place. I don't normally talk about these things, but, you know, I just wanted to have an answer. 25 machines were distributed to manual scavengers, and an entire bus I gave as a contribution to the municipal corporation, which is used to, you know, clean up the sewers and stuff. I actually asked the manual scavenger, about 2 or 3 of them came because 25 of them couldn't come altogether. And I asked them their names, their address, their mobile numbers. And I made a small little plaque, which I put on the machine. And I said, now don't go and sell this. Use this for your own safety. I haven't heard of those machines. I haven't heard about their lives. But just a couple of months ago, we read, you know, about deaths happening of manual scavengers who'd gone down into the sewer and died. What can we do and what needs to be done to repair this?
Last words of the Bachchanji, I could not hear.
I just wanted to know, what is the condition of manual scavengers right now? What are the efforts being made? There's a lot of things that are being promised on paper, but that was, you know, 7-8 years ago, and just wanted to know what the situation is right now. Despite the fact that a lot of people have made individual contributions. I mean, I'm talking about it myself because I can give an example. I don't normally want to talk about these things because I believe the charity needs to be done and not talked about.
Sir, first of all, thank you so much. You have taken the personal initiation to show the way for the country. But only one, my submission is individuals can make a little change in the society, but through the policy intervention, we have to expect much more changes, because it is not the problem of just one place or Aurangabad or Maharashtra or some other state. It is the problem of the whole pan-India problem. And the problem is also deep understanding we need to have. It is not just the solution is the mechanization. The sanitation is also is linked with the caste and the patriarchy. So we have to deal with this also. How we allow another human being to come and enter into our septic tank. So the people must understand. The person who is coming and cleaning is in another way. But actually the persons who are engaging, they are not feeling anything bad about that. We think that it is okay if somebody is coming. Because there is an M mindset, which is the caste mindset. So we must work out more on for this. And second most important, I would like to bring to your notice, important to the nation is, there are the another 49 districts in the country where women still going and carrying human excreta, bare hands, and taking to the dumping gas still continuing. So we are celebrating Bapuji's birthday after birthday, and it has been 150 and 151. It will go on. But actually, we are not putting an end to the inhuman practices. Why in the human society? India, like the great country, can go along with the human scavenging. And why we have to lose the life of the people? They maybe belong to the Dalit community, vast majority, or maybe another, whatever. Why? Our technologies are so big. Why the companies are not coming forward? Why the government has not come with a policy document stating very clearly in all our cities, whether we have other facilities or not, but we will not allow any human being enter into the manhole or the septic tank. So that has not happened. Why this completely silence from the government side? I am unable to understand. I think that the only reason is we do have in our mind that somebody is dying because they are all the Dalits, the scheduled caste or somebody, and they are the poor, oppressed. So their voices as an... See, we have the difference of the life. So we don't value all lives equally. If you give the equal of the every life is in a matter like, definitely we will find a solution within the 24 hours. Yeah. Your efforts really appreciable, sir. There is no doubt.
But Mr. Bayswater, you know, simple things like a dress for them to wear that protects them from, you know, any kind of disease or injury, or some breathing mask so that they don't die from, you know, the bad fumigation that comes. Also, the fact that you mentioned about, you know, the caste, this is not a platform to talk about caste, but, you know, there are institutions, Mr. Bayswater, and there are human beings. And there is one very particular gentleman who has worked on this issue. I'm not going to talk about the caste because he comes from a higher caste, and he actually gave a demonstration of working with the Dalits and picking up human excreta himself with his own hands, much against a lot of objection that came from his caste and from the people of his family. But, you know, these are examples that need to be explored, that need to be talked about. Otherwise, this problem is going to remain with us eternally.
The solutions we have to find out very systematically. I lost.
We actually honored them on in our KBC Kambi.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yes. Robin.
Me? Yeah.
Sorry?
Yeah, Mr. Bayswater, please go right ahead, sir.
Yeah.
You were saying.
This is, this is a good example that others are also is working, but whoever working, that is the reason I mentioned that any human being is the most important.
But the problem is there is a link between the caste and the patriarchy that we cannot ignore. And this debate is going from the Mahatma Gandhi and Ambedkar times. It is not we are starting this debate, but we have to find the solution within the framework of the Indian constitution. How do we come out of this? And it is many people, like a person like you. You have a special interest on the eradicating this whole practice of the manual scavenging. Definitely, we as an Indians, as an Indian citizens, we everybody must take an action to stop this, the human scavenging and garbage and all this thing. And a simple example is even during the COVID season, we have not provided the proper mask and the gloves to the sanitation workers. Why? And we have not paid the salaries. When everybody is sitting inside the house and protecting our life, the Safai Karmacharis, they came out and they have given their service by putting their life under the risk. But we have not paid the salaries. And see, that is what I want to say, that our actions come like we want to actually shower the flowers on them. Who want the shower? Flowers on the, like a shower. We want the salaries. We want the mask, gloves, all protective gear, which we are failed to supply. Why? When it is coming to the doctors, we give, but sanitation worker, we don't provide. Why? So there is an understanding itself. This hierarchy must go, and we must treat everybody as equal. So there, I think that the major problem is that we must look with the Baba Sahib Ambedkar lens, everybody as equal. No nafrat. There is nothing like that.
Yeah, some amount of equality, as you're talking about, is very essential, Mr. Baiswara. Because when you were saying earlier that, you know, this community believes that they have been born for this job, I disagree with that. Because a lot of these people that came out said, we want to go and look for another job, but we are discriminated against because of the kind of job that we are doing presently, and nobody wants to give us a job. So this discrimination, this inequality has to be removed from our social thinking. Otherwise, this problem is never going to be solved.
I think that that is the only way. We must understand that there is an unequal society where we are living, and we must put an ad stick. We have to build the equal society in the 21st century. India is the greatest country. We have everything. So now we have to put all of us, say that even the patriarchy, we must stop. Why this is a violence on the women is happening. So that is also linked with the scavenging, sanitation, rape, so violence. All these things must go. Actually, October 2nd is the right time to discuss about all these things.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we have no time to think about actually the harmonious society. And you are spending the whole day for this. Why? So you have a special interest on this. We must make India as a clean India. Yes, of course, we everybody. But the only my submission is the sanitation workers, the Safai Karmacharis, who are given and giving their life for the actually to make India as a clean, their rights and their entitlements, we have to actually safeguard and protect.
Yeah. You know, actually, Sanket, in one of the earlier meetings that we had here on the program, we actually called, as I said, we had called 2-3 of these sanitary workers. Mm-hmm. And Jaya was also on the program. Mm-hmm. And she said, you know, the MPs get, you know, MP quotas.
Yeah.
And she said, you know, you come to me, I'll give you jobs.
Wow.
And they never came. Mm. They just didn't come. It's just some kind of a social discrimination that has taken place. And it's really sad.
Absolutely.
Because they risk their lives every day. I mean, I just keep talking about it again. I made a donation of these 50 machines and told them, use this, you don't have to go inside there. Pata nahi kahan hai wo, istemal kiya, nahi kiya, kya kiya.
They become nameless and faceless, and that's the biggest tragedy.
Absolutely.
It's also kind of intimidation that usually they face where technology is concerned. So because I've been working not with scavenger hunters personally, but in other areas, you know, and that's why I keep kind of reiterating that knowledge is power. And there's a certain kind of intimidation that comes in, you know, when they see a new machine or when they see something that can potentially take over.
हमने जब वो मशीन मंगवाई ना, हम अपने घर में से ही उनको ही दिया था.
जी.
दो तीन को हमने उसको कहा कि डेमोंस्ट्रेशन दो. फिर उनको बताया कि किस तरह ये चलाया जाता है. यू डोंट हैव टू गो इन. इट्स अ लॉन्ग स्टील रॉड दैट गोज इन एंड यू ऑपरेट इट फ्रॉम आउटसाइड मैन्युअली एंड इट स्टार्ट्स डज ऑल द क्लीनिंग वर्क.
बिकॉज़ आई मीन व्हेन आई थिंक ऑफ इट जस्ट द एक्ट ऑफ डूइंग व्हाट दे डू इज इनह्यूमन ऑन सो मेनी लेवल्स विद एनी काइंड ऑफ बेसिक protection,
very inhuman.
Nothing. They get poisoned, they get bit, they are in the middle of...
No, they die because they of the fumes.
We read about it so often and it's very heartbreaking.
Yeah.
You know, Bhumi, I believe you have to go to Mr. Rohit Kumar Singh.
Yes.
One point that I wanted to mention, I met him in 2004 in Rajasthan. He was the chairman and managing director of Rajasthan Roadways. He's always been the people's bureaucrat. Babus are usually known not to, you know, they have a very negative image. This man you're about to talk to is not like that.
That's very exciting. Well, joining us now is Mr. Rohit Kumar Singh, Additional Chief Secretary, Government of Rajasthan, Rural Development and Panchayati Raj. Is sir here? So, sir, you have worked closely in the fight against COVID-19. Recently, you have written about how the state plans to make sure that no one is left behind for the vaccine once it's out. Please tell us more about it.
I think when the infection came to Rajasthan in the month of March, we had two parallel problems. One was how to prevent the spread of infection, and one was how to treat people. So we worked equally on both fronts. And we, for example, in Bhilwara, suddenly two doctors of the biggest hospital got infected. And we had this challenge because we knew these doctors were in the OPD seeing patients, and the patients were coming from different villages. So we suddenly realized the magnitude of the problem. And what got compounded was one foreign channel said that Bhilwara is going to be the next Italy. That hurt here. And we realized and we decided that we are not going to let it happen. And we will make sure that Bhilwara becomes a model. So what we followed was the principle of ruthless containment. We said everybody's going to stay home. But we realized with our experience in the civil services of 30 years that if you're going to inconvenience people, you have to ensure that their daily needs, the essential food items, the milk, the medicine, etc., has to be taken care of. And people have to be on their side, on your side. If people become your adversary in the times of crisis, then the problem goes out of hand. So we followed that principle. We said, you stay at home and we will provide you all that you need, but please don't come out of your homes. And the second thing we did was we proactively went to each house and we developed quickly an app, and we decided to survey everyone with what is called ILI, influenza-like illness symptoms. And we quickly had a database of who is likely, who is vulnerable, because their age was there, their medical history was there. We also used technology, shared data from Ayushman Bharat. So we worked on all fronts. And as it always happens in Rajasthan, Sanket Ji has worked in Rajasthan, he would know that Rajasthan has this tradition of tying tradition with technology in governance. So you asked about the vaccine rollout. We are already onto the preparatory mode. We realized that within 3-4 months, the vaccine will be available. But that is not the end of the problem. That is the beginning of problem number two. How do you roll out the vaccine in a safe, coordinated, and equitable manner? Because we are country's largest state when it comes to geographical area. How do you ensure that you maintain the cold chain? How do you make sure that it reaches the last mile? How do you create a record of who's vaccinated, who's not vaccinated? And I would refer to the two articles written by Mr. Nandan Nilekani in Hindustan Times a couple of months back, where he said, maybe a month back, where he said that like we rolled out Aadhaar, we have to have an authentication mechanism in the vaccine rollout also. So now I used to be health secretary. Now I am the secretary of rural development, Panchayati Raj. So we have decided to engage. I have 1,80,000 self-help groups of women that comprise about 20 lakh members. So we are now sensitizing them and training them that you get involved in not only maintaining the last mile of the cold chain, but you also be involved in rolling out the vaccine. Of course, you are not healthcare workers, so somebody else will put the injection in, but you have to be there to sensitize people for what is called IEC, information, education, communication. You get the people for vaccination. So unless we plan, even if the vaccine becomes available, it will be very difficult to have a robust rollout mechanism. Right. So that is what we are planning all about.
All right, Mr. Rohit Kumar Singh, thank you so much and keep up with the good work. So I've worked with him. I mean, I was a journalist in Rajasthan when he was a bureaucrat and, you know, again, solutions driven.
Yeah.
So that's a, he's had a stint at the center also. So that's how he is. So in just a short moment from now, Ambika Singh, my colleague, is also going to join us. But hygiene is the second pillar of our telethon. So we spoke about environment. Uske baad ab hum hygiene ki bhi baat kar lete hain. Swasth mantra. Safe sanitation and hygiene is crucial in preventing pandemics like COVID-19. The first line of defense against most infections is hand washing. Experts around the world tell us that it saves lives. This becomes more imperative for any infection or disease transmitted by contact, whether human to human or human to surface. And right now, hand washing is key in the fight against the coronavirus.
The first line of defense against most infections is hand washing. Experts around the world tell us that it saves lives. This becomes more imperative for any infection or disease transmitted by contact, whether human to human or human to surface. And right now, hand washing is key in the fight against coronavirus. It's optimum for at least 20 seconds at key times, from lathering the back of your hands, between your fingers and under your nails, and then drying it with a clean towel. But COVID-19 is not the only germ we need to protect ourselves from. Seasonal influenza, colds and other viruses will continue to be a concern. So good hand hygiene and proper disinfection practices are habits we need to inculcate in our daily lives. Our first step towards a healthy future starts with clean hands.
Something as basic as cleaning your hands. Hand hygiene, and not just cleaning, keeping them clean in different ways. And there's one such model that is being spoken about of hand hygiene at Adra. Let's go across to Lucknow to know more about this. Saurabh Shukla, aapko aawaz aa rahi hai, bataiye Adra ke bare mein.
Yes, absolutely. I can. Ji bilkul, hum is waqt Lucknow ke ek primary school mein hain. और यहाँ पर जैसे कि आपको पता है कि 15 तारीख से 15 अक्टूबर से स्कूल खुल सकते हैं, तो आद्रा ने यहाँ के प्राइमरी स्कूल के साथ में, यहाँ के शिक्षा अधिकारी के साथ मिलकर पूरी तैयारी की है. ये ऋतिक हैं, ये आपको दिखाएंगे कैसे इन्होंने, जब बच्चे आएंगे तो ये हैंड सैनिटाइज करेंगे, और हैंड सैनिटाइज करने के बाद में यहाँ.
ओके, वी सीम टू हैव लॉस्ट दैट वीडियो कनेक्शन. व्हाट टू डू विद सिग्नल हाइजीन, Bachchan Saab?
Yeah, we're all suffering.
Absolutely. Who will drop the call drop, as they say? But you know, yeah, we've got Saurabh Shukla back. Saurabh, bataiye.
Boy, just sanitized his hand, and they have prepared a selfie corner right here. And after sanitizing, he's showing his hands, and they've prepared a soap bank as well. They will put the card inside, they will get the soap out, and this is how the classroom is going to look. They have called few students to try. We have there's a principal ma'am also of this primary school. The Adra official is also here. Sir, aapka naam bataiye aur kaise taiyari karai hai aapne in schoolon mein?
Mera naam Amit Shukla hai, project manager Adra India UP and Bihar. Yahan pe ye taiyari pehle se hi pichle 2 saal se karyakram chal raha hai, banega swachh India. अभी ये बनेगा स्वस्थ इंडिया हो गया, तो इसमें ये है कि आगे कोविड के बाद कैसे बच्चे स्कूल आएंगे, उसके मानक के तहत ये पूरा एक प्रिपरेशन तैयार किया गया. यहाँ पे हाइजीन कॉर्नर है, ये हाइजीन कॉर्नर है जिसमें हम पूरा ये मटेरियल स्कूल को प्रोवाइड कराते हैं, जिसके माध्यम से ये बच्चे सीखते हैं, खेल खेल के माध्यम से सीखते हैं कब हमें हाथ धुलना चाहिए, कब कब हाथ धुलना चाहिए, कैसे धुलना चाहिए, अच्छी आदत क्या है, हाथ धुलने की बुरी आदत क्या है, टॉयलेट कैसे यूज करना है, इन सब के बारे में हमारे जो टीचर्स हैं वो बताते हैं, सिखाते हैं।
प्रिंसिपल मैम, अब तैयारी हो गई है स्कूल खोलने की, आप कैसे 15 तारीख से हो सकता है खुलें, तो बच्चों को कैसे बुलाएंगे, इतने बच्चों को कैसे क्लासरूम में रखेंगे, सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग कैसे मेंटेन कराएंगे?
सरकार के द्वारा गाइडलाइन जारी हो गई है, तो हम लोग, क्योंकि बच्चे बहुत ज्यादा हैं और सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग को हमें फॉलो करना है, तो हम रोटेट कर देंगे बच्चों को और उनको हम स्कूल में बुलाएंगे और कम बच्चों को बुलाएंगे और अल्टरनेट डेज कर देंगे जिससे कि बच्चे आए और अपना होमवर्क ले जाएं। हमारे क्या स्मार्ट क्लासेस भी हैं, उनके द्वारा हम लोग
संकेत दैट्स हाउ द क्लासरूम इज गोइंग टू लुक, दे हैव कॉल्ड फ्यू स्टूडेंट्स फॉर ट्रायल एंड दैट्स हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू मेंटेन सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग and I've joined by a small girl, she's 5 year old, her name is Isha and she has prepared a song for our Bapu, Mahatma Gandhi, today is his birthday. Isha, gana sunayenge aap, kaun sa gana suna rahi thi, sunaiye.
Nanni si hasi boli si khush phoolo si बोलो सिवराहे भूल गए जब देखिन दी आवाज हमें, हम घर की राहें भूल गए, हम सोए नहीं कई रातों से जाने वते सौ चांद बुझे, हमें आजाद बिना हमें नींद सी दिन आएगी जब देखेंगे आबाद तुझे, तेरी मिट्टी में मिल जावा गुल बन के मैं खिल जावा, इतनी सी है दिल की आरज़ू, तेरी नदियों में बह जावा तेरे खेतों रावा, कितनी सी है दिल की आरज़ू।
Sanket Isha, she's 6 year old, she's student of first class and she has prepared this song for 2nd October and that is Mahatma Gandhi's birthday today and that's it from Lucknow and that's how the classrooms are going to look when school gets reopened with full social distancing, with the hygiene corner, and in these hygiene corners you will have the sanitizers, towels, buckets, and that's how Adra has prepared these primary schools along with the basic Siksha Adhikari is also here. And sir, I'll just speak to him also. Sir, आप सरकार की तरफ से हैं और बड़ी चुनौती होने वाली है कि अब कोविड के टाइम पर स्कूल खुलेंगे, तो आप लोगों ने सरकार की तरफ से इन स्कूलों में क्या तैयारी कर रखी है?
देखिए, सभी शिक्षकों को बता दिया गया है जो कोविड 19 के प्रोटोकॉल है उसको पालन करें, कोई भी बच्चा बिना मास्क के ना आए और सैनिटाइजर और हैंड वॉशिंग की पूरी व्यवस्था की जाए। विद्यालयों में ज़्यादातर में मल्टीपल हैंड वॉश की सुविधा भी है और इसके अलावा कंपोजिट ग्रांट की धनराशि भेजी गई है, उसमें निर्देश है कि उसका 10% धनराशि खर्च की जाएगी सैनिटाइजेशन में और स्वच्छता के संबंध में।
आपने पैसे भी दिए हैं स्कूल,
वित्त की कोई समस्या नहीं, आर्थिक रूप से सभी लोग को समृद्ध किया गया,
पूरा सपोर्ट मिलेगा। सो आई विल जस्ट लीव यू विद द पिक्चर ऑफ बापू एंड लाल बहादुर शास्त्री, दे हैव प्रिपेयर्ड एंड दे हैव जस्ट हियर एंड दे आर सेइंग दैट स्टूडेंट्स वांट टू कम बैक टू स्कूल एंड दे आर सेइंग दे आर गेटिंग बोर्ड, सो दैट्स इट फ्रॉम लखनऊ। संकेत,
फॉर द लास्ट great, that was wonderful, wonderful report, thanks very much. And that little girl singing, beautiful. Amitabh, could you sing like that when you were her age?
I could, but I'm not going to do it now. I know where you're going, Pranay.
I thought you and I together, you know.
Yeah, we'll have to go back to, you know, good old Calcutta days. Actually, you know, Pranay, I was just wanting to interrupt here when I was watching all these kids doing.
Yes.
They're so innovative. You know, last night, my granddaughter, Radhya, was seeing, you know, KBC and she called me and said, you know, this corona in my meaning means the crown, but actually it is corona. Matlab, don't do.
Wow.
Corona.
Lovely.
Wow. Brilliant.
I thought that was brilliant. Yeah.
They teach us
no one ever
all
thought
the
about
time.
It. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, she's
करो.
She's definitely got Jaya's genes. Yeah.
Thanks so much, Parna. I was Brilliant. Expecting that.
Brilliant. Chalo, we'll sing later in Bengali. But okay. Let's go across to a really special leader in the medical world, Pratap Reddy. He's the founder and chairman, of course, of Apollo Hospitals. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us. We've watched you for years build up this huge medical service. But this, do you feel that the corona situation, the pandemic, has raised awareness that India needs much more medical expenditure, medical care, develop our medical systems to a much higher degree? And this is really time to do it now.
Thank you, Pranay. I'm very happy to participate. We've been doing this from 2014. Our wonderful, wonderful, generous Amitabh Bachchan as the ambassador in all of these. So I compliment NDTV and the ambassador. But I'm also happy Dettol is involved in this. Because they're also doing a program. I have adopted 60,000 people in my mandal, where I was born, from first breath to the last breath. That means the child before is born, we take care of the mother. We give her nutrition 2 times a day, supplement her vitamins, minerals, whatever that is needed. And the delivery is done at our premises. I'm happy to say last 3 years, we had no neonatal or maternal mortality. Because we're taking all the precautions to keep it safe in every single respect. And there, I think, infection plays a great role, especially when you talk about rural India. The hygiene and is a very, very important aspect. I'm happy Dettol has played a significant role. Last 1.5 years, they've been there. Where they're tackling only the children. But what we are telling the children is take this lesson to your parents. So I think it has an impact on those 65,000 villages or 102 hamlets in place where I was born. But your question was about this infection. What are we doing enough
in India?
The first answer is
in the health sector. Yeah,
in the health sector. First, I should say, the government acted quickly. Whatever they thought was necessary, putting the controls, bringing back the essential equipment like PPPs and all of these. And then they geared up the healthcare community, the public healthcare. I must admire them, the doctors, the nurses, the paramedics, the whole lot. And the private healthcare, we also joined them and did whatever we could in each and every respect. Because none of us were prepared for this. This is where I think we learned the first lesson. What is needed? What are the medicine? Because there was everybody had no clue. It was only in the beginning a life-sustaining program that all the private or even the government of private hospitals, which we put them in intensive care units, what we did. But later on, we adopted the three things that have made a significant impact, especially when it is given. And the results have shown initial mortalities were close to 3%. Now all, whether it's private or public, the mortality figures have dropped below 1.7, 1.5. Sometimes even in my district hospital where we are handling, it is less than 1. So I think this is where we have learned the lesson, implemented it with our own adaptability. I think you can't give the same dose, same thing, because our people wait and things are different. So we have learned it. But what is most important today, the people who got into problem are people who were not just COVID infection. People also had other comorbidities. You know, I must tell you, way back in 2005 or 2006, World Economic Forum made a broad warning that second decade of this 20th century will have severe crisis from NCDs, non-communicable diseases. What are these non-communicable diseases? Diabetes, heart attacks, strokes, cancer and infection, and I had a sixth one to it, obesity. This six morbidity will cause almost 80% of the deaths by end of 2030. That is in this one decade. And they have also said the cost burden for the world will be $30 trillion. For India, it's going to be $3.8 trillion. What is $3.8 trillion, which is more than 50% of GDP? And to answer your question, should government spend more money than what they are doing now? They have increased from 1 to 1.2 to 1.25. So where is 50%? Where is this? I think what is reasonably required was, we have been pleading saying that if the government can poke close to 3% and above, the private is spending now 5% through insurance. If that goes up to by 2%, 7 plus 3, 10%, I think can make a significant impact in not only managing disease. I think we should now talk, when you talk about the future crisis or even the present crisis for COVID, our greater efforts is to see how can we prevent COVID infection. We set a 3 golden formulas for that. Similarly, I think for the NCD crisis, we have said, what we have done is, we have done a large number of the health checks, probably the largest number in the world. Using artificial intelligence, we have now derived a, what's called a personalized health check, which can detect when you do 5 people's blood samples, it's 5 different tests, but it's specifically focused if they have any one of these 6 COVID problems. If they have early enough, if it is diabetes, there's a sure cure for diabetes. I'm one of those. My blood sugar was 370 45 years ago when I was struggling for this Apollo. Today, my blood sugar this morning was 88. So I think it's completely controllable and all the complications of diabetes will disappear. Similarly, the most important is the heart. Unfortunately, the heart attack in the West and now it's India is different. In West, it takes place in the 60s and 80s. Unfortunately, in India, it used to happen in 30s and 50s. Now even we see now 25-year-olds getting a heart attack. So I think it can make a very significant impact if they go through the checkup, find out the status of their health, and then listen to whatever prevention. So I think prevention, like you are here saying, cleanliness will make a significant impact in avoiding COVID infection. There, I think it will have the NCD crisis.
Thank you so much, Dr. Reddy, for sharing your expertise with us. I think what you said, prevention is the key. You know, we need to take care of ourselves and self-care. That's what we're talking about. Thank you so much for joining us.